The truth is out there, apparently, lurking behind some cosmic gas cloud or perched on an asteroid hellbent for our galaxy. The search for alien life has always been at the back of our collective brains, constantly asking the question, where are all the aliens? Surely if there was alien life out there, then it would have had the manners to pop by our planet and at least say hello. Right? Well, science fiction has painted a multitude of pictures on how that would exactly play out, but for the most part, the appearance of alien life has been relatively stereotypical. Little green men, pointy-headed, grey-skinned, long-limbed fellows, maybe even a few tentacles every now and then. But the universe is full of billions of varying forces and factors, all of which have an influence on how life may have evolved. So, let's take a look at it, shall we? Hello, Internet, what's going on? And once again, welcome back to the most inquisitive channel on YouTube, Life's Biggest Questions. As per usual, I'll be your disembodied floating voice, Jack Finch, as today we curiously ask the question, what do aliens actually look like? Roll the clip.
Alien, look what I made
for you. For the curious amongst you, that clip was from Steven Spielberg's 1982 heart-wrenching classic, E.T. the Extraterrestrial. And if our hypothetical alien race were as kind, curious, and caring as our boy E.T., then we'd be a very lucky planet indeed, glowing fingers included. And it leads us to an important opening motion. Historically, Hollywood has depicted alien life as wholly humanoid-based entities. Two arms, two legs, two eyes, a neck. But really, it's anyone's guess what form alien life would or could take. Evolution has a habit of finding the most efficient way possible to further the successes of life. As my man Jeff Goldblum says in Jurassic Park, life finds a way. But that doesn't necessarily mean it finds that way on two legs. To first hypothesize what alien life would look like, we can turn to our oceans and take a look at the most remote branch of the evolutionary tree, octopuses. Not octopi, as some may claim, but nevertheless, our eight-legged friends are a great example of the form that life could take on a remote alien world. In fact, the octopus has often been theorized to actually be an alien species. And in 2018, scientists published a hypothesis that the octopus was a result of an icy asteroid filled with frozen octopus eggs that crash-landed in our oceans some 540 million years ago during what is known as the Cambrian explosion. And although it's not widely accepted by the field of science, it addresses some interesting points. As we know, octopuses have incredibly complex nervous systems, camera-like eyes, and even the capacity for camouflage and the ability to turn themselves relatively invisible. As this paper explains, the genes for these alien adaptations do not seem to have come from any octopus ancestors, but instead seem to be borrowed from a far distant terrestrial evolution. Spooky, right? Well, although the evidence isn't exactly clear and present, the fact of the matter remains that whatever form life takes, it has a pretty clear-cut checklist to make sure it can be classed as sentient. Firstly, life has to find out exactly what mushy or non-mushy matter it's made from. Now, although all life on our planet is carbon-based, it is definitely not outside the realm of possibility that alien life could take a much different form. It's highly possible that alien life could be silicon-based, because, in fact, silicon is one of the most common elements in the universe. And although molecularly similar to carbon, it wouldn't rely on water, but instead ammonia or perhaps methane. And it doesn't just end at silicon, because it is entirely possible that alien life could be made from iron, titanium, aluminium, magnesium, and even sulfur. Now, you might be thinking, what the hell, Jack? An alien creature made from titanium? That's terrifying. And, well, yeah, it could be, but don't worry, because we're made from carbon, yet we don't exactly have pencil fingers, do we? And that's not even the most terrifying, because it's entirely in the realm of plausibility that alien life could be comprised of arsenic, or even random dust particles suspended in some electromagnetic plasma. Yeah. You get the picture. Whatever biochemical form it takes, though, it's a given that alien life will need some form of brain to give it the intelligence necessary to make it from the confines of its planet out into the cosmos. And because of that brain, it will need some form of protective mechanism that ensures it doesn't easily get bashed to pieces by predators. Perhaps an exoskeleton, some form of chitin, or a skull similar to ours and our mammalian cousins. For that brain to succeed, they'd need some form of sensory system, which for the most part would definitely depend on the environment that they'd evolved in. You may think our hypothetical alien species would have to have at least two eyes to ensure that it can see the civilization that it's built, and that's partly correct. A minimum of two eyes are essential to perceive distance, but with just one, it would equal zero spatial awareness and a quick extinction for the species if they can't see predators coming from a distance. But that perhaps wouldn't always be the case. Take bats, for instance, a species that have evolved completely in darkness, and while not completely blind, they use echolocation to navigate their environment. Again, a plausible notion for our alien species, but we can go one further, because the notion of sensory perception is only applicable to how our brain can comprehend our perception of things. It is entirely plausible that an alien species could use stellar radiation as a sensory array, detecting minute changes in radiation to form a perception of its environment, giving away entirely the need for eyes and ears. Yeah, that one would be pretty crazy, but really, we only have eyes because of our planet's proximity to our sun, and our need to differentiate between the electromagnetic spectrum. Some aliens could see in infrared, ultraviolet, or not at all. Any form of sensory perception would inevitably need some semblance of communication to coordinate in social groups, which would eventually lead to some form of society and then civilization, but that one is literally anyone's guess. Communication could indeed be just like ours through voice or hand signals, eventually leading to written text and mass media, but that's just the evolution of our species. This particular alien life may have evolved their communication through the secretion of pheromones to denote positive or negative instruction, as well as a spectrum of emotion, or perhaps even a complex series of blinking phosphorescent patches on their face or body. Whichever method they had harnessed, though, communication is integral to civilization, and without it, they would never collectively reach the stars. Now, as we know, intelligent communication eventually dictates the need for technology, which would have began with the use of some form of basic tools. To build tools, our hypothetical alien species would need some kind of manipulative digits like our fingers, although not necessarily an opposable thumb, as any number of prehensile tentacles would suffice. I'm looking at you, Cthulhu. But the fact of the matter is, that point is only reliant on the environment that this alien life evolved in. You see, we need tools on our physical plane of Earth because of the thousands upon thousands of malleable minerals and materials that have led to our technology in manipulating matter. But it is entirely possible that sentient alien life could have evolved in a gaseous or liquid atmosphere, not necessarily even on a solid planet. In that case, these aliens could be nothing more than sentient clouds floating about in the cosmos without the need for tools, their brain comprised of a series of electrostatic nerve endings, expanding and condensing at will. They could be so far removed from our perception of what life actually is that perhaps we'd never even realize that they were in fact an entire alien civilization. We may think that alien life has to adhere to the same set of principles that have led to our species' evolution, but that is based entirely on our known perception of what life actually is. But the only thing that we can be certain about alien life is that it finds a way. What that way turns out to be is anyone's guess entirely. That's also without factoring in technologically advanced means of space travel, as it's in the realm of possibility that whatever organic or inorganic species evolved to the point of being an intergalactic civilization could have completely lost any resemblance of their physical form. To ensure the means of spending eons in space, our hypothetical alien species could have advanced to the point that they deemed it necessary to upload their consciousness to a machine. We may never even meet our alien neighbors in the humanoid capacity. Heck, they could very well be a giant robotic head floating about the cosmos, shouting, "Show me what you got." Wow, that's pretty exciting, isn't it? There we have it, our comprehensive answer to the question, what do aliens actually look like? And I, for one, can't wait to find out. What about you guys? How do you see it? Let us know your thoughts down in the comment section below. Before we depart from today's video, though, let's take a quick look at some of your more resounding remarks from over the past few days. First up, Charles Enoch says, if you just cleaned a vacuum cleaner, wouldn't that make you the vacuum cleaner? Wow. Wow, Charles. I think you may be onto something there. Well, that's the kind of thing that would get you far in life, my good man. So, good job, Charles Enoch. Good job. Well, on that note, I'm pretty sure no one can top that. So unfortunately, that's all we've got time for in today's video. Just stick around all the way until the end. If you're a fan of this video, make sure to hit that thumbs up button as well as that subscribe bell, and we'll be seeing you in the next one. As per usual, I've been your disembodied floating voice, Jack Finch. You've been watching Life's Biggest Questions, and until next time.